It's very important to the process of understanding Google Cloud and passing the certification exam that you go through the question and attempt answering it yourself first. So pause the video, work through the question. We'll catch up in just a little while and I'll show you how I do it. In this project scenario, you need to create a large number of projects for many different teams. You want to use a cloud deployment manager deployment to create those projects in a folder called My Folder. What should you do? So there are many projects for many different teams. The requirement is that we necessarily have to use Cloud Deployment Manager. And we have to create these projects in a folder called My Folder. What would be the recommended approach in this situation? Now, even when I was reading this question, I was trying to map out what will we need as part of the answer. What is expected in the answer that we choose? So, one, we have to be able to create projects. If you have to create projects, somebody needs to have a project creator role. And this permission has to be on the folder. Now remember, when we say folder here, we are talking about a folder in the resource hierarchy. Organization, multiple folders, then projects, and then resources like VMs and memory and hard disk. So this is not a regular folder that we are talking about. And the resource here is the folder on which this permission needs to be available. And of course, this permission needs to be with somebody. Why? Because IAM is essentially what? Identity and access management defines who can do what on which resource. Now, we know what needs to be done. We need to be able to create a project. And we need to know where it needs to be done. It has to be inside a folder. Okay, and that's the resource within which this has to happen. Now, the question is, who can do it? Given that there are many projects and many teams, I would ideally prefer that this is not done manually by a person who logs in. If it has to be automated, done by a system, then it is preferable that we have a service account. Now, it's not a necessity, but it would be nice to have. With those few points that are already in our mind, let's move on and look at each of the options. Option A suggests that you have the project creator role on My Folder. Then you create the deployment using the gcloud deployment manager deployments create with the option --folder My Folder. Let's see if some of these are good and if some of them don't work. So the first one says we need a project creator role on My Folder. So what can they do? Create the project. Where? On My Folder, and that will be required, right? So that definitely is a yes. The way you create deployments is using that command, gcloud deployment manager deployments create. So that's also good. However, there is no direct option to specify a folder as part of the deployment manager command saying --folder equal to My Folder. So that option not being available, we have to eliminate this option A. Option B suggests most of the same things. You have the project creator role on My Folder, and you use the gcloud deployment manager deployments create, and provide an option of the label as act as whatever is your email address. So again, this doesn't have a service account. It is you who's logging in and doing this and providing your credentials. Now, what are labels in Deployment Manager? A label is just a key value pair that helps you organize deployments. Based on that, then you can manage your inventory. So you could have probably a label like environment production, environment staging, environment testing, just to separate out the resources that you have in each of these areas. You could also maybe do it based on department and various other things, whichever you choose and whichever is appropriate for your organization. Now, with that understanding, let's look at option B and what all it suggests. It's very similar in the beginning part to the previous one, that we have a project creator role on my folder. That's fine. We use the gcloud deployment manager deployments create. That's also fine. However, labels are user defined. These labels are not interpreted by the gcloud command. So even if there was something that you define called act as me at example.com, gcloud doesn't understand that and is not able to use that as part of the deployment. So this approach of just adding a label is not going to work, and we have to eliminate option B. Option B suggests that we first whitelist the deployment manager API on my folder. Then by using the constraint / service user.services, which is an organizational policy constraint, we create the deployment after that using the gcloud deployment manager deployments create with the option -- folder my folder. Now we have already eliminated -- folder thing in option A, but let's still learn a little about organization policy constraints. What is an organization policy constraint? It configures certain restrictions at the organization level which are inherited by all the child resources. But of course, it need not be only at the organization level, it can be at any of the resource levels, and it's inherited by the resources under that. Specifically, now you don't need to know this to answer this question correctly, but if you did go look at constraint / service user.services, you will also see that it allows you to deny a set of services, but doesn't allow you to say these services are allowed on it. Right? So it's kind of via negativa rather than via positiva. Given that, let's first see the paths that we already understand, right? That the gcloud command is fine, but there is no option to specify a folder, so we straight away eliminated this. But let's also consider the other aspects. We need the ability to have deployment manager APIs available to us to use, right? So it's kind of indicating that, hey, those APIs are enabled, fair enough. But using the organization policy constraint, we can't enable, say, the project creator role. With the organization policy constraint, we are denying, hey, you're not allowed to do these services, but does not automatically enable project creator. So given that, for multiple reasons, we can eliminate option C as being not possible. Option D is a little longer now. It suggests manually create a project called My Project. Fair enough, we can do that, not a problem. We enable the DM API in this project. Okay, so if we have to execute some of the deployment manager APIs, we need to have that enabled somewhere. And we're saying we are going to do that in this custom project. So far, so good. Then we list the service accounts in the project, identify the one used by deployment manager. This is going the direction of what we wanted, that we did not want somebody logging in with the account. We'd ideally like to have this automated or done via the VM, via the system, for which a service account is appropriate. Now, instead of giving the project creator role to a user, we are now assigning that role to this service account for that folder. Given all of that, we can now use a gcloud deployment manager deployments create command with the option -- project. So we do know that each of these paths are now adding to the solution. We need the DM API, and it can be called from the current project. Once that is there, since there are many teams, we can use automation via a service account to have these projects created for multiple projects and multiple teams. To create the project, the project creator role is required on for that service account and on that folder, in which case we have given the proper IAM permissions, and now the whole solution is complete. The rest of it we already know. The gcloud command is correct, and we are running it from the project with the DM API involved, which allows us to call those APIs. All of that considered, option D therefore becomes the right choice for this question. Well, how are you going to inform others of the super GCP content? Just one way: like it, share it, let them get to know of it, and you subscribe.